In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words
in. For our good night message on this Friday, the 28th of October, 2022, the Feast of Simon and Jude, broadcasting from the Salesian Novitiate in Kawe, Central Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. We listen to lessons from Simon the Zealot. Today we celebrated the feast of two apostles, Simon and Jude. Nothing much is known about both of them, but one thing we know is that Simon was a zealot, and on him we want to focus in tonight's goodnight message. The zealot movement was founded by Judas the Galilean, who attempted a revolt against the Roman government around AD 6. Because of a tax-related decree to conduct a census. Interestingly, this Judas is also mentioned by Gamaliel in Acts chapter 5, verse 37. Religiously, the zealots were very similar to the Pharisees. This meant that they believed in the immortality of the soul, in a final judgment after death, and a physical resurrection. The Pharisees were very virtuous, obviously gaining a good reputation among the people, and therefore able to be very persuasive in their doctrines concerning worship. They practiced modesty, despising delicacies in their diet. The Pharisees tended to be apolitical. Politically, the zealots were described to have had an inviolable attachment to liberty. They believed that only God had the right to rule over the Jewish nation, that Jews were cowards if they would endure to pay a tax to the Romans and would, after God, submit to mortal men as their lords. Therefore, they thought they were doing God's work by rebelling against Roman soldiers and leaders, even killing some of them. They were political extremists. A related subgroup called the Sicarii, or assassins, who wore concealed daggers, were even more extreme, carrying out planned assassination attempts. Of note is a mention of this group in Acts chapter 21, verse 38. It is often said that Barabbas, the prisoner released on Passover instead of Jesus Christ, was actually a member of the zealots. These were criminals. And these zealots wanted change to come instantly. And they were going to do it by a sword. And here's a lesson we learn from Simon the Zealot. He gave up his passions and ideologies to follow Christ. Simon the Zealot teaches us this lesson. If we are to believe and continue living the path of Jesus Christ, we should eventually give up our passions and ideologies that we may have adopted over time, especially when they are in conflict with the Lord Jesus' teachings. I don't know what your passion is. I don't know what you have been attached to before you met Christ. Even after meeting Christ, you might have been found with a passion of wanting to preserve your own marriage that took you to a witch doctor, and you are keeping those herbs in your house because you want to use your human strength to keep your marriage that comes from God. You have to give up that. Give up those herbs that you think are going to keep you in employment. Give up those herbs that you are keeping in your office and let Jesus take over. Learn from Simon the Zealot, who threw away his sword and embraced the sword of the Word of God to become passionate about preaching the Word, about doing the right thing in Jesus' name. And I know you can do it. And I know you have your own ideologies, you have your own attachments that are more giving human solutions to things rather than divine solution. May Simon the Zealot be an example in your life to do the right thing and live according to God's will.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
Changing me and changing you, we have come.